what the Quran says? The Quran speaks about how Allah has created man. الله الذي خلقكم من ضعف ثم جعل من بعد ضعف قوة ثم جعل من بعد قوة ضعفا وشيبا. Allah has created you, O man, in a stage of weakness. You were weak when you were born, very weak. So what happened? Someone had to look after you. If they didn't, your survival was at stake. After that weakness, we gave you strength. And after that strength, we reduced you back to weakness and gray hair, which means it's worse than just weakness. You were strong at one stage, you become a person weak once again. And I believe that sometimes, and I'm going to say something, you know, that you might think about later. When you are young, you might mess your napkin and your mother will clean it. Your father might help, or your siblings, or whoever else. Where did you miss? You missed because your sphincter muscle was not actually controlled. It was not strong enough to hold back. You didn't know how to use it. So perhaps urinated, perhaps you might have messed your napkin, whatever it was. That was a gift that Allah bestowed upon you. Your parents need to know, I sacrificed for the child. But when a person grows older, they may not miss that way. They may miss from their mouth. Remember this carefully. Why? Dirtier words than changing the napkin can come out from elderly people who are in pain sometimes, who are frustrated sometimes, where there's a generation gap and they don't understand. If there's more than, nowadays I'd like to say 25 years, 30 years, between you and your parents, there's bound to be a generation gap, understanding gap. Bound to be. Remember this. Usually they used to say 40 years is a generation, completely different thinking. But I think it's gone a little bit less now, because technology is advancing every minute. So the way I think might not be the way my children who are 25 years younger than me may think. I will, no matter how cool a dad I think I'm going to be, or a father-in-law, or a mother-in-law, there will be differences in thinking, because there's a generation gap. So out of frustration, sometimes you say things that are hard, harsh. You don't realize that's not your child, it's someone else's daughter, someone else's son. You've hurt them. When someone else hurts the child of another person, the hurt is deeper, the cut is deeper than if it was your own child. Remember that. Be careful. Now I'm addressing those who were hurt by what the elderly have said to you. Ignore it. Change the nappy and carry on. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. If you've understood what I've said. Let it happen. The next day they'll beg for forgiveness. They might carry. The difficulty is sometimes the elderly are stubborn. They don't ask for forgiveness. Come what may, they are wrong. We found out that they said 1 + 1 = 3 and the whole dunya knows it's 2. They won't apologize. It's 3. It's 3. I'm telling you it's 3. You say, no, but it's 2. Who said you can't subtract 1 from 3? So that's the type of answers you get. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us. These people are witty, they are sharp, they know. Sometimes they don't apologize. Because why? I'm an elderly person. Who are you that I must apologize to you? My beloved elderly, a lot of you are geniuses. You don't make those mistakes. But if you do, subhanAllah, please apologize. Please apologize, learn to make amends. We don't want our children's marriages to break because we are putting pressure on our daughters-in-law or sons-in-law or anyone else. But something that happens when you get old and you are in pain, your level of tolerance becomes very, very less. The level is low, very low. Your fuse becomes 5 amps when it was 15 before. Any small thing and it's blown. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us. So sometimes, and I know, usually when you hear a little bit of a rant, you hear something, you know, you can say, subhanallah, you're in pain, you'll say, hey, really, so, you know, subhanallah, it happens because that's how the body operates sometimes. You vent out something in a different way without realizing it's wrong, no matter what, it's wrong.